Hey everybody, this is Cody B here in Salt Lake City, Utah. Welcome to our Relationship Marketing Weekly Show. Well, I tell you, I am so excited for the show we have for you today. We have a very, very special guest with us today in a very unique industry, and very excited. We had the opportunity to have a little pre-show discussion, and I learned a lot from our guest already, and you get to learn a lot from her now. The interesting thing is our guest today is brand new using a relationship marketing system. So a lot of our previous guests have used our system for a period of time and they've gotten really good at it and all that kind of stuff. Our guest today from a very unique niche, she's actually a franchise owner, runs a retail shop. We're going to talk about that in a second. She's brand new using this stuff. She's like 30 days into using the service that helps her implement relationship marketing and already got phenomenal results. So without further ado, I want to welcome a very special guest today, Debbie Miller, who is a franchise owner out of Greensburg, Pennsylvania. Debbie, welcome to the show today.
Hi, Cody. Thank you.
Well, we sure appreciate you taking the time to be on our show with us today. It looks like you are in your retail shop there. Tell us a little bit. By the way, the name of your store is Big Frog Custom T-Shirts. You're part of a franchise organization. There's close to 100 franchises called Big Frog Custom T-Shirts. You own one of those franchises, and you're sitting in it right now. Tell us a little bit about Big Frog T-Shirts. Why do you want to sell T-Shirts, Debbie? Talk to us about your deal there.
Well, I started with this 6 years ago, pretty fresh out of college, and needed a graphic design job, and came into this business was just opening up here with the previous owner, and I got hired with him right off the bat and just loved the business itself. We have some really great customers here. You get to meet people from all aspects of life who come in, because everybody wears a shirt and everybody needs a t-shirt. So everybody is a potential customer with this business.
So you have a lot of walk-ins that they're retail customers. They're just individuals that buy individual shirts. You also have business owners business owners that buy lots of shirts? What kind of clientele do you have like that?
It's really all over the board. Business owners, schools, clubs, teams, churches, family reunions, really anybody, any kind of event that they're doing, if they want to commemorate it in a unique way, they can get t-shirts for everybody attending. And we can do the one-off, the gag gift, the birthday present, the I just saw this design and wanted it and wanted to wear it. And that's how we have the business here. Being able to print one, starting with one for a person, they find out what we do, how we do it, and they come back and buy 100.
Oh, that's great. That's great. So I can come into your store and buy right off the shelf, or I can come in with a design of some kind and you build whatever I want, basically.
Yeah, what's really unique with Big Frog is that we have graphic designers on site all of the time. So when you enter the store, you're greeted and they help you decide what color shirt, what size, the style of shirt. And from there, they'll actually put the design together on screen for you in front of you. So you can check and make sure everything's the colors that you like, the fonts and typefaces that you like, images. You can bring in photographs. We'll print full color photographs on t-shirts for you. And we can have things ready for you the next day. So very fast turnaround as well.
Very, very cool. Okay, so you worked for a franchise owner for, like you said, 5 or 6 years, right? Mm-hmm. And then recently you actually purchased the franchise from your old boss. Is that right?
That's correct, yes.
So you are the boss now.
Yes.
You get to do what you want to do now in running this shop, right?
Yes, but not too much has changed.
Yeah. Well, this is a question I had, and I know a lot of our listeners will have. When I think of a franchise, I think a franchise, if I buy a franchise, the franchise kind of tells me exactly what to do. So I'm assuming that your franchise recommends ways to advertise and market your store and your service out in the marketplace. But you have come in and you've done something different than most of the other franchises. So I wanted to ask you about that. What are other Big Frog t-shirt shops doing And how is it that you're able to do what you want, basically? I mean, just tell us a little bit about the rules of your franchise.
Well, they do recommend various marketing practices, and as long as we abide by the logo standards and whatnot, then we are able to proceed with most of the marketing tactics that you might envision. Other stores have had a lot of success with the face-to-face marketing with communities and getting out and going to community events and festivals. And in this case, I needed to do a marketing event in the winter months. So I went to doing the mailer, to doing this Send Out Cards campaign, and was very happy with the results.
Well, let's talk a little bit about that campaign, because a lot of people are listening in today because they've seen some incredible results that you've gotten. You send out a campaign to 500 customers and got like 12 times return. So this is one of the very first things that you did. So I want to talk a little bit about that. First of all, you came in and you bought the franchise, and with the franchise, you told me earlier that you had a database of about 8,000 people that have purchased from that store before. Is that correct?
Yes.
So you're really smart in that the very first thing you did is you went to your database to mine the database. Most people say, well, what new people can I go find? And they go try to advertise out there to bring in new people. One of the first things you did is you went to the existing group and said, okay, who from this group should I reach out to? Which kudos to you, because that's it's amazing. That just seems like common sense. But I'm telling you, most people don't do that. It's crazy. So one of the first things you did is you went to your database of 8,000 people and you, well, you tell the story. What did you do? What was the first thing you did there?
Well, with having this new store, or taking over the ownership of it, you know, everybody's on a budget when they're marketing, and your, I guess, most cost-effective marketing are your repeat and referral customers. So these are customers who I either had worked with in the past and personally knew, and knew that they would remember me when seeing this logo again, or customers that hadn't been here in some time and maybe were ready to see our logo again and remember that, oh yes, I had purchased this a while ago. I had a great experience when I was in the store. I'm looking for this again. I'm going to go back. So that was the drive and motivation behind putting together this campaign.
Okay, so when you did that, you ended up with a list of 500. So you had 8,000 names to choose from, but you ended up with a list of 500 people. I guess what you would call a VIP list.
Mm-hmm.
And based on, you know, buying activity and, you know, like you said, buying activity and how recently they've been in the store, those kinds of things. So you end up with this list of 500 names. Tell us, and by the way, you just started using this system in December. Like, when we're not talking a year ago December, we're talking like last month, December. You barely just started using this. So the story that you're telling right now, I want to make sure our viewers understand that this is one of the very first things you did only about 30 days ago. So you created a list of 500. Show us what did you send out to that group and what happened?
Sure. It was a postcard. And it was designed as a coupon format. Because anytime that we send something, I do like to see how effective it is. So that's where we put the coupon on there to try and bring people back into the store so that we can track the response of it. And it not only brought back people with the coupon, but people coming and saying that they did receive it, or family member received it. They saw our logo on that card somehow and came into the store because of that.
Excellent. So you sent out 500 of those and you got, what were the results? What started happening?
Well, the next day when people started receiving them in their mailboxes, we started getting them the next day and they just continued to come in. We saw the bulk of them prior to the holiday. This did hit mailboxes December 5th, and with the holiday right around the corner, it was very effective in reaching people when they were looking to purchase or looking for gifts.
So I've got notes here that say that you think that because you monitor as they bring the cards in and what bring the postcards in with them because they get a discount. Mm-hmm. And you got like 50 people. So out of 550 people, I mean, what is that, 10%?
Yes.
10% response on a mailer piece is phenomenal.
I mean, and trackable too.
Trackable, exactly.
Yes.
So 10% response on this mail piece. Why do you think that was so successful? By the way, for our listeners, 500 went out, 50 people came in, generated $5,000 in incremental sales for you, all within about a 2-week period of time. That's sales you probably would not have gotten at all had you not have done this campaign. What do you attribute that success to? Why was this so successful?
Well, a lot of it was the timing and the people that it went to, but also the platform. It was very easy to put together. I actually didn't mention earlier that I didn't have much time to put this together because I was due with a baby girl any day at that point.
Wow. And
I needed to have something marketing for me whenever I couldn't be out marketing. And this, as I said, hit the mailboxes December 5th, and she was born on the 12th. So...
No, wait a minute. So the story gets better. So through all this, you had a baby too?
Yes.
Well, congratulations, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
Wow, that is amazing. So it just goes to show you there's no excuses out there, business owners. I mean, Debbie's 9 months pregnant and she gets one of these things out and goes and has the baby and has these kind of results with something as simple as what you did. It's really cool. Now, one of the things a lot of your other franchises do that you had mentioned is they actually do a lot of bulk mailing, direct mail pieces. What you like about the send out card system is that you can really customize and get real more personal with people. Mm-hmm. So tell us a little bit, like you're brand new in this. Tell us a little bit, what do you plan to do in the future with your customers using the send out card system? Because I've noticed it's real important to you to get personal and customize it to the person you're sending to. Tell us some of your ideas of what you plan to do.
Oh, well, that's what I appreciate most about Send Out Cards. And a lot of the motivation for me joining this franchise was because of that interaction with customers. This business offers a very unique customer service level that really separates us from competition in that regard, and that we have so many repeats. You know who they are when they come in the door. They tell you a little bit about them, and you remember that for their next visit. And that's where Send Out Cards is really going to be a great addition to our relationship marketing campaigns here, in that we'll be able to take those personal touches that people tell us when they come in. If we have a grandmother that comes in and says she just had a new grandbaby and she bought a onesie for them, and it put the Nana's favorite or Gaga's favorite on the onesie, we can then send her a card using that information again and just reminding her that we helped her with that and she had a great experience in the store
So what you plan to do is somebody comes in, gives you an order, you're going to build a custom t-shirt design for that customer.
Mm-hmm.
While the shirt's coming off of the press, so you can see the process of the shirt being made, you plan to take a picture of that, put it on a greeting card and send it out as a thank you card to that customer, right?
Yes, that is something we're hoping to incorporate. We have a very unique printing process in that what the customer sees on screen and what they designed on screen with that designer when they were in the store is pretty much what comes out of the printer. And it's very, very fun to watch their product being made. So that's something that they typically wouldn't be able to see. But if we take a picture while we're printing it and send them that thank you card with that picture, it adds that additional element of their experience with the store here and with Big Frog.
You know, what's interesting is, you know, I've been doing what I do for 15 years now and represented a system that companies can use to follow up with their clients. And I've gone into retail store after retail store over the last 15 years, showed them this system and said, you know, you guys really should send out thank you cards to the people that come into your store. What's interesting to me is retail establishments are, they're real late adopters to what we do. It's like retail owners don't want to send thank you cards. They don't seem to see the value in it or whatever. So you're kind of you're an early adopter here, and it's really interesting because you've already had great success, and it's going to be great to see that, because I know there's no question this is not a test. I know beyond a shadow of a doubt, with all the businesses I've helped, hundreds of thousands of businesses over the last 15 years, I know as well as we sit here that you will be massively successful with this. Like, your franchise will break records. I'm telling you right now, I'm going to bring you back on this show in 6 months. Let's do that. Let's make it the deal right now. Bart, you guys in the background, we're going to bring you back on in 6 months, and we're going to talk about how what you featured and what you're doing with the send out card system has catapulted you to the top of the franchises for Big Frog custom t-shirts. I'm that confident. And I just kudos to you for having the fortitude and having the vision to do this.
Well, thank you. I should probably mention that this past December was a record-breaking month for our store here. In part thanks to send out cards and some wonderful employees who worked very hard this past month as well when I wasn't here. The store had a record-breaking month in sales as well as customers through the door. So very exciting in that regard. And we're looking forward to more months with that and moving forward and seeing the positive results of this campaign.
Excellent. Hey, a special shout out to, you have a special mentor that's helped you set up this relationship marketing system. Carol Regina, we haven't forgotten about you, Carol. You've done a lot to help out this whole movement, to help Debbie out with this. And before the show started, she couldn't stop talking about how gracious you were. And we have independent relationship marketing specialists all over the country that can help people like you set things up. And, you know, at the end of the day, we just want to help businesses be nice to their customers. That's all we do. It's that we just, and when you're, what you send out in life is what comes back to you. So if you're nice to people, they're going to be nice to you. I don't know why this is rocket. There's no rocket science here. It's the most effective marketing system in the world using common sense principles. So, Debbie, thank you so much for the time you've spent with us. Any final words of wisdom or any advice that you can give our listeners as we close out?
Well, I guess as a business owner, what we've found to be one of the most successful parts of growing the business is to do what you say you are going to do for that customer. If you tell them we're going to do this by this time, do it by that time. If you say you're going to send them a proof or call them, send them that proof, call them. And that's what creates your repeat and loyal and really wonderful customers who are excited to come in the door again and again.
Excellent. Debbie Miller, thank you so much for the time you spent with us. Please come back on our show 6 months from now. It's going to be an incredible story. What we'll do is we'll feature little highlights of this show talking about how we're going to come back in 6 months. And then we're going to do a show 6 months from now. And I'm telling you, you're going to have some incredible stories to share with everybody. So thanks again. Appreciate your time. Look forward to having everybody share this story with all your friends on Facebook. And we'll see you next week. We'll have another great show next week. Take care, everybody, now.